When Steel Talks, everybody listens.
Steel Talks is here in the village at New York University's famed Frederick Law Theater, and we have here Professor Jonathan Haas, who is the director of NYU's percussion program. And New York Steel Drum Ensemble has just completed a beautiful performance, and it was really good.
So. Wasn't that just great? I'm still dancing and hearing the tunes and bopping.
So tell us a bit more about how the steel drum program came to be at New York University.
Well, when I started teaching here 7 years ago, I thought that one of the most important elements of what we're going to teach is for our students to get involved in the community, in the world, and what better way than with steel drums. We're the first major university on the Eastern Seaboard to begin a program like this. And we didn't know, would they learn it, how quickly would it take? And within one semester, everybody was completely involved in the music and just also having a great time. But the interesting thing about steel drums is that there's a lot of theory, music theory, that they're learning to play Beethoven and Mozart and Mahler. And when you apply it to the music that comes from the Caribbean, from Trinidad, the similarities are astonishing, and one supports the other.
Okay, so tell us a bit more. We understand that for all the percussion majors, the steel drum and learning to play every voice of the steel pan instrument is mandatory. It's not optional.
Exactly. Well, I did that because if you leave it up to young people, you know, sometimes they just want to sleep late. But now, in the case of our percussion program, I made it a requirement so that everybody would have to learn the instrument. And there was never a fuss. There was never a student going, well, you know, I'm just too busy or I have too much schoolwork. And this has become actually the highlight of everybody's week. So it's no longer mandatory. All we got to do is just do it. And they love practicing. And as you heard in the concert tonight, they just memorized an hour and a half of some very, very difficult music, very complex. And of course, this is all very new to them. They've never done anything like this.
Okay, because your manager or one of your co-managers, you have two, that's Farley J. Joseph and James Spittle.
That's right.
Jamie shared with us, he's from Florida. I asked him what he thought about the steel drum being an integral component, not optional. And he said actually that's why he chose your program at NYU. That was the deciding factor as a percussion major, that the steel drum was definitely part of it. And so do you have many people doing inquiries saying, well, look, the steel drum is something that I really want to get into and even go further?
Well, the answer to your question is that students, when they come to NYU, they don't have a background in these instruments. So they're very surprised. At first, when they're freshmen, they're very worried. How am I going to learn how to play a new instrument? And I'm coming to study an instrument that I already know how to play. And I think that it's sort of that mystique, you know, what's going to happen that would attract somebody. But we don't have steel pan players who come to NYU to study steel pans. What's happening, though, which is wonderful, is that people who are in the steel pan community in New York City, Brooklyn, and the surrounding area, they want to join our ensemble. So what does that do is that when we bring in more people and the diversity becomes greater and greater, my students are going to rub off on them.
Yeah.
And this is really the exceptional experience of bringing many different cultures together. We hope to be in Trinidad next January.
Okay, this sounds good.
And take our ensemble down there and go to the pan yards and study more in depth than we do. And also maybe we'll get a chance to play.
And you were looking at perhaps doing a Philip Glass music concert down there if you do make it down to Trinidad, right?
Yes. Well, we have our CD is coming out in May. We're very, very proud of this. No steel pan organization has ever played his music, and we're the only steel pan ensemble allowed to play his music. He's a big rock star now, and I actually really love his music. And when everybody hears his music played on steel pan, I think it's a winner.
So what did Mr. Glass think of the collaboration, or should I say also the initial time that he was introduced to steel drums interpreting his music?
I think he thought I was out of my mind. I think he said, I have no idea what's going to happen. And then when we presented to him the final product, I think that he was really, really surprised. And one of the things we're trying to do is to convince him to write us a piece.
Specifically for NYU.
For NYU Steel. So, well, you know, it may take me a little while. He's a very busy man. But he's thrilled. It wouldn't be coming out on his record label if he didn't really like what he heard.
So is there another concert in the offing at some point before next spring from NYU Steel?
This was our final concert of the year.
Oh, okay.
And they actually have lots of other concerts and finals, and then they'll all go off in the summer. Mm-hmm. And we come back in September in full force.
Looking forward to maybe another one maybe for maybe Christmas or before?
Oh, absolutely. First semester at Christmas time we'll have a concert. Second week in September, we're going to Albany to play at a Steelpan festival. So we're at the point now where I think people, we had a big audience tonight. Steel Talks was very helpful, by the way, and thank you for the support and everybody's support.
It was a pleasure.
When Steel Talks, it's these are the sorts of things that I think that my students really gain by. And what you're doing for the music and for the people who love this music is a great benefit.
Okay, I mean, it's really, really great when you have such a superb performance. I mean, and to come into the heart of Greenwich Village and find a thriving, vibrant steel ensemble is something that can only be said to be really, really great for the art form. So, okay. Professor Haas, thank you so much
for
chatting with Wednesday Steel Talks. We will be following. And congratulations to yourself, to Josh Cullen, the director.
Oh, Josh, what an amazing job.
I did not mention Josh.
Oh,
Josh Cullen, your director.
Put him right up at the top.
NYU Steel, and a fantastic job. To you, the program, all the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
When Steel Talks, everybody listen.